many manifestations of the dual. All the manifestations, the various types of manifestations that you see as life today, fundamentally rooted in the duality. Because there is two, there is many. If there was one, there would have been only one. When I say two, the duality is like light and darkness, male and female, life and death. Because the two is there, all the games are happening. If there was only one, there wouldn't be any game. There would be just existence. The many manifestations, as I said, are fundamentally rooted in the duality. Once duality comes, sex comes. When I say sex, probably in most people's mind, the man is thinking of a woman, the woman is thinking of a man. It's not like that. The birds are blooming. It is sex. Because what you call as sex is the duality is trying to meet. And in the process of the duality meeting, there are also certain functions that the nature wants to fulfill, like procreation and survival of that species. Always the duality is trying to meet, because what was one has manifested itself as two. Now there is a longing to become one all the time. This longing to become one finds expression in many ways. When you're young and your intelligence is hijacked by your hormones, sex will be the way, physical sex will be the way. When you become middle-aged, when your intelligence is hijacked by your emotion, then love is the way. When you transcend all this, then if you seek the same union in a much higher level of awareness, then we say it's yoga or the divine. There are many names. Now, these two energies, which in the human race we are calling as male and female, it's in every way we are referring to the same way. Always constantly trying to come together at the same time. Except for this longing to be together, there is nothing common between them. They're lovers and enemies at the same time. Constantly this is going on because they're opposites. If they look for similarities, there is nowhere, no common ground. But the attraction of the opposite is always there. What you call as opposite is always a relative thing. The whole process of what we are referring to as sex is just two opposites making an attempt to become one. The intention of sex is good, but the method is hopeless. Never are you going to really become one. The intention is fine, that you want to become one, but the method is quite hopeless, isn't it? Pleasure is involved, so it draws people, but oneness never really came. So we are trying to meet in other areas of emotion and intellect, trying to find some common ground. We like the same things, we like the same kind of ice cream, we like the same color. Like this, people are trying to find common ground. But actually there is no common ground. Unless you understand that there is no common ground, it is just that you learn to enjoy the opposite. It just becomes a hopeless thing. To make a simple physical act beautiful, we have invented all kinds of decorations around it. Without those decorations, most people would be unwilling to get into this physical act. A lot of people cannot simply face the basic physical act as it is, because unless it's decorated, they will feel obscene. They will feel like an animal. They will feel so basic and physical, which is the reality. In some way, we are trying to cloud our vision of reality with lots of decorations. We always add emotion to it, because without emotion, it would be ugly. Today in the modern world, see, sex is a natural thing. Sexuality is invented by you. You understand? Sex is a natural thing. It's physical. It's there in the body. But sexuality is something that you invented, you created. It's psychological. There is no such thing. It is something created by you. Today, this is sweeping the world. It is no more healthy. In so many ways, it's become sick. Because if sex is in the body, it's fine. It's beautiful. The moment it enters your mind, it becomes a perversion. It has no business with your mind. It has something to do with your body. If it's in the body, it will just fall into its natural place where it belongs. It is a small aspect of you. But today, it has become a huge aspect. It has just become life itself. If you look at the modern societies now, I would say probably 90% of human energy is being spent either pursuing sex or avoiding sex, whichever way. Yes or no? Whichever way, that has become a huge aspect. It is just a small thing. If you look at a man and a woman, physiologically it is just a small difference. Like somebody said, either the pocket is in or the pocket is out. With one the equipment is inbuilt, with one another the equipment is hanging out. You made such a big issue out of it, you know. This simple physical process, we are trying to make it so many things which it is not. It is just nature's trick to reproduce. Because if this attraction was not there, you wouldn't reproduce. The species would end right now. But now we made such a distinction between man and woman as if they are two separate species. We are going about treating everything, man and woman separately, as if they are two separate species, they are not the same species. No other creature on the planet has this kind of problem with their sex as man has. When they have it in their body, they have it. Otherwise, they are free from it. But with humans, it is on their mind all the time, endlessly. One big reason why this has happened is, somewhere in the past, especially your religions, especially in the West, it is not so much in the East. Especially in the West, your religions went about denying a simple physical process to such an extent that they even have to make it so ugly that they could not accept the simple biology of a human being. See, religion means liberation, isn't it? Yes. Religion means freedom. How can there be liberation? How can there be freedom when you cannot even accept the biology of a human being? They could not even accept the simple biology of a human being. So we went on saying that instead of looking beyond the limitations of the biological process, we tried to deny the biological process.